Howdy, we're here at County Line Luber today. We get asked a lot of questions about products, sheet goods, thicknesses, distances, all kinds of measurement type questions. So I'm here today to try to explain to you the different thicknesses and sheetings. And I think once I do this, it'll become very much easily understandable for you. This is called OSB. In the field, they refer to it as wafer board. It is not plywood. People call it that, they should not. OSB stands for oriented strand board, okay? These are chips that are laid up in a certain way and pressed into a certain thickness that is required by engineers for your house. The most common one is this one here, which is 7/16 inch thick. Keep in mind, again, all lumber is nominally sized. So 7/16 in the field is referred to as half, much as is even more confusing, 15/32, which is more of a true half. Okay, 99% of your wall sheeting on a house is in 7/16 OSB. When they get to the roof in our area, they generally go to a 15/32 and sometimes even a 19/32, which you would know as 5/8. We generally do that on a heavier roof, sometimes even in tile, okay? The reason you would go to a half inch product or 15/32 is obviously it's stronger than a 7/16. The other thing in our market area with 7/16, we are required on a roof to apply what's called a ply clip or a roof sheeting clip. What these are for, these would attach to the OSB in such a manner in between your trusses to keep the wave from occurring on the, generally the track home houses use this a lot. So if we clip this, now we prevent the sagging in between the trusses over time. And as I told you this, you will see that on certain older track homes, okay? This clip is hard to put on, hard to carry, and you end up dropping most of them. It is what it is. So if you go to 15/32, yes, that's a little bit more money, you do not are required to use these clips. So 90% of the roofs in our area, we highly recommend 15/32 in our marketplace. I'm William Dean II. God bless America.